So we are discussing about file organization, and in the last class we have seen the organization of different kinds of files. For example, we have seen that what is a file or what is a sequential file. Then we have said that in case of a file, it is basically storage of raw data before you process the data and put it into proper format. So because in case of file, the data may come in any form, and whichever form it comes, you have to store it into the file. So the information in case of file has to be explicit. That means whatever field of a record you want to store, the name of the field and the value of that field must appear in name and value pair, so that the file can be processed later on to put the file in a proper form. In case of sequential file, we have said that sequential file is a sequence of records. And usually what is done is, in case of sequential file, the records are put in a particular order, either in the ascending order, usually in the ascending order, or the descending order of a particular field, which is called a key field. So whenever we want to search for a particular record with a particular key value, then the search can be made efficient. But because these files or the different blocks containing the records are stored in the blocks, so unlike in case of searching for a particular record in case of main memory, where we can have an efficient search mechanism, for example, binary search, which is not very effective in case of sequential search. So we have seen that an improvement over the sequential file organization is what is an indexed sequential file organization. So what is done in case of indexed sequential file is, your main file is stored still in the form of a sequential file. That is, it consists of a number of records, the records containing a number of fields. Obviously, one of the fields we'll be calling as key field. The sequential file, the main file, is stored in the form of sequential manner, where the records will be stored in ascending or descending order of the key field. We'll have one or more additional files, which are called as index files. So these are the index files. And this is your main file. The index file will mainly consist of two fields. One is the key field, okay, and the other one is the pointer field. So when we set this index file, this is nothing but a sequence of key field and pointer field array. Okay, so different key fields or different pointer fields in this index file point to different records in the main file. So if I have, say, 1,000 entries in the main file, what I can do is, out of 1,000, I can extract, say, 20 of the key fields in such a way that the key values are uniformly distributed in this main file. So those 20 key values will be the indexes put in the index file. Okay. So in the first level index, we'll have 20 entries of key and pointer pair. So every pointer of a particular key pointer pair will point to an entry in the main file, which corresponds to the corresponding key field. Okay. So like this, I can have, if I take, say, 20 key fields, all these 20 pointers will point to 20 different locations in the main file. Then I can have second level index. Maybe, so out of these 20 pointers or 20 key values that we have stored in the first level index, out of that I can select the 5, and those 5 will be the entries in the second level index file. They will again have key pointer pair, and these pointers now will point to the different entries in the first level index file. Then this way we can go on, and what we effectively have is a pyramid structure. Okay. So if I put the index files like this and search for a particular record in the main file using these index values, then the number of search operation that has to be performed is quite less. That makes the access of the file system quite efficient. But still, the other problem in case of sequential file that remains, that whenever we want to insert a record, the record has to be put into the main file. Okay. Then we have seen that in case of sequential file, we make use of a transaction file or a log file. So whenever you insert a new record, you don't try to insert it into the main file immediately. Rather, what you do is you put it either in the transaction file or the log file. Then at regular intervals, that log file can be merged with the sequential file and still maintaining the particular order of the key values in which the main file is stored. Okay. Similarly, again in this case, whenever a new record is to be inserted, instead of trying to put that record immediately into the main file, what is done is the record is put in an additional file, which is similar to log file or transaction file, or this may also be called an overflow file. So whenever I have to insert a new record in the main file, what I do is I insert that record in this overflow file. Then where this one should go into the main file, for that we have to maintain a pointer. Okay. So all the records in this main file, in addition to the fields that are necessary for the record, you maintain an additional field of pointer. Okay. So every record in the main file will contain a pointer which will be used to point to a particular entry into the overflow file. Okay. Suppose in the main file I have two entries. So for one entry the key value was something like 60, and for the other entry the key value was something like 75. In absence of any overflow file, what we do is keep all these pointer values equal to null. That means they don't point to anything. Now, in case I have to put a record, insert a record with key value of say 75, key value of say 72. Now, this record, when merged with the main file, should come in between 60 and 75, because this is 72, and I am assuming that the main file is stored in ascending order of the key field. Okay, so in this case, what is done is you take that record within the main file with the largest key value and less than the key value of the new record that will be put. Okay, and set the pointer value, pointer field in this record pointing to the entry in the overflow file. Okay, so similarly, whenever I insert other records, I want to insert more and more records into the main file, all these records, new records, will be placed in the overflow file with the pointers in the main file appropriately set. Okay. So with this, I get two advantages. Firstly, whenever I want to merge this overflow file with this main file, I can follow these pointers in the main file to see that which file, which record should come where. Okay. So that gives an advantage when we try to merge this main file with the overflow file. Secondly, before merging, if I want to search for a record, say 75, okay, then even with this overflow file, I can search that, search for a record with key value, say 72. But even if this particular record is not there in the main file, but if it is existing in the overflow file, even then I can search for it. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll search this main file in a sequential manner, and firstly I'll have to follow this indexing to identify the block where this record number 72 should appear. Go to that block, search that block sequentially. Okay. Within the block, when I encounter such a situation that I have a previous record with key value 60, next record with key value 75. 72 is less than 75 but greater than 60. So it should come in between. So in such case, what I have to do is, I have to follow the pointer in 60. If the pointer is set to null, that tells me that this record does not exist. If the pointer is not null and it is pointing to the overflow file, then the location where it points, that gives me the location where this new record with key value equal to 72 exists, and I can access that particular block and subsequently the record. Okay. Now, in this situation, if I have to insert another record with the key value equal to something like 74, okay, then what I can do is I can go for second level of overflow file, or even if I have additional empty locations in this same overflow file, what I can do is I can put that new record here with pointer with key value equal to 74, and the pointer field in this overflow file will now point to this location. Okay. So following these pointers, I can go from a main file to a overflow file, or even from overflow file to overflow file itself, and these situations will occur if I have to insert a new file before the merging of the previous overflow file has taken place. Okay. So this is the advantage that you get in case of indexed sequential file. There is another kind of indexing that can be employed, which is called a tree structured indexing, or tree index. And typically, the type of tree that is used is what is known as B plus tree indexed file. Now, what is this B plus T? Those who have done the earlier course on data structure, we have discussed about some tree like binary tree or balanced binary tree, binary search tree, and all those things. And in case of binary search tree, we have seen that the binary tree is formed in such a way that the left child of a node is always having a value less than the root node, parent node. The right child will be greater than or usually greater than the parent. Okay. Now, if we organize the file structure in the same fashion, in this case, it is not really a binary tree, so it is called a P plus tree. Okay. And in case of balanced binary tree, we have seen that the tree is arranged such that the difference of depth of the left subtree and the right subtree is at the most one. Okay, if the difference becomes more than one, in that case we have to readjust the entire binary tree so that the balanced nature of the binary tree still remains. Now, if I want to use the same concept for the file organization, then what is done is, in this kind of tree, that is B plus tree, I'll again have two kinds of nodes. One node will be the leaf node, and I'll have non-leaf nodes. It is the leaf nodes which actually contains the records, or the leaf nodes are the blocks containing the records. The non-leaf nodes, they contain the key values along with the pointers. Okay, so if I want to search for a particular record with a given key value, what I do is I start from the root, take with the key values stored in that root node, that which of the paths or which of the pointers I should follow to come to the proper block containing the desired record. Okay, so the structure of the file, structure of the tree will be something like this. I have to have a root node. The root node will contain a number of pointers and a number of key values. Okay, so something like this. Usually, this contains the n number of pointers and n minus 1 number of key values. So in this particular case, if I say that these are the pointer fields, then this contains 3 pointers and it will contain 2 key values. Of course, how many pointers and how many key values will be contained in every block, that depends upon what is the size of the block, how many bytes you need for storing every key value, how many bytes you need for storing every pointer value. Okay, so accordingly, we can decide that how many pointers and how many key values can be stored in every block. Right? So in this case, we are assuming that this node assuming that a block contains a single node, this node contains say three pointers and two key values. Okay. Now within this, the key values will be stored in a particular order, maybe in ascending order. So if I took key values ki and kj, okay. So first key value is ki and kj, second key value is kj, then ki will be greater than kj if I is greater than j. That means the first key value that I stored should be greater than the second, should be less than the second key value that I have. Okay, that is, keys within a particular node are stored in ascending order. Now, whenever I want to search for a particular record with the key value equal to kp, okay, what I do is I come to a non-leaf node. Usually, I start from the root node. I check these key values with the key of the record that is being searched. Okay, if I find that this kp is less than the first key value, then I will search. I will follow the left pointer. If kp is greater than or equal to this key value but less than this key value, then I will follow this pointer. If kp is greater than or equal to this key value, then I will follow the rightmost pointer. That should be the search strategy. Okay, so let us put it like this. Suppose I have two key values in this. This is my root node, and here suppose I have two key values. Let us put one key value as say 500 and other key value maybe say 1150. Okay, and the nodes are put like this. So as I said, that for every key value which is less than 500 should follow this path. Okay. Now here, maybe I have the key value say, let us put any number, say 200, 300, here it may be 500, maybe 600, maybe say 1150 itself. And here I may have, say, 1300. Okay. Here, let me assume that this level of the nodes that I have, they are actually the leaf nodes which contains the records. Key values are unique. There is still a key value. I'm not duplicating the records. It's a key value. It just tells me that which path I should follow. Okay. When it comes to these blocks, which contains the records, here I'll have only one entry for every key value. Right? So it is like this. So here I can have different records containing the key values, say 200, 201, all these things. All these key values, records with key values must be less than 200. Sorry, this should be 200. So here I have to put say 100, 101 and all these things. If I have to follow this right path, then records with key values which are greater than or equal to 200 will be stored, but they must be less than 300. When I follow right path, this rightmost link, then all the records with key values 300 or more will be stored. But all those must be less than 500. Okay. So this way I have to store. Here, similarly, I can have key values 101, 200, 201, like this. Here I can have records, so 300, 301, all these things. Okay. So whenever I have to search for any particular record with a given key value, I start from the root node, check the key value with the key values which are stored in the root nodes. If I find that the record that I am searching with a key value, say KP, KP is less than 500, I will follow this left link. Okay, if KP is greater than or equal to 500, I will follow this right link. Greater than or equal to 500, but less than 1150, then I will follow this link. If it is greater than or equal to 1150, then I will follow this right most link. Okay, now after coming here, if I find that the key value that I am searching, that was less than 500, so I have followed this path. Here I check whether it is less than 200. If it is less than 200, I will follow this path, come to this block, and I know that the record containing this particular key will be contained in this block only. So I will read this block and extract the record. If it is greater than or equal to 200 but less than 300, I will follow this path, come to this particular block, read this block, okay, and extract the corresponding record. If it is greater than or equal to 300, then I have to follow this path, come to this block, read this block, and extract the corresponding record. Okay. Now, whenever such a type of file is stored, it may be necessary that in some cases, because whenever I want to put a new record, the new record has to be placed in one of these leaf nodes. The new record cannot be placed in any of the root nodes, any of the non-leaf nodes. Okay. Now, one restriction that is followed is to maintain the balanced structure of this tree, that is, a node can be at the most half empty. Okay. That is, in this case, it should be greater than or equal to half full. That is, in this case, because every pointer, every node, non-leaf node, can contain three pointers, I will not allow a situation where I have a non-leaf node with only one pointer, except the last one, where I cannot have any control. Okay. So to maintain the balanced nature, what I have to do is, every such non-leaf node should have at least two pointers. So accordingly, the blocks here will be organized. Okay. So I can have two different situations, that whenever I want to insert a new record with a particular key value, I have to search out for that block starting from here, starting from the root node, I have to search out for the block which should contain that new record. If I find that I have space in that block for containing this new record, the new record will be placed in that block. But again, this ordered nature has to be maintained. But if I find that this new block is full, say for example here, my condition is something like this, that here I can have records with key values less than 200. Here, I will have records with key values greater than or equal to 200, but less than 300. Okay. Now, suppose I have to insert a new record with key values of 199. Okay. So, for this 199, firstly, I have to search for the block which should contain this record. I start from the root node, find that 199 is less than 500, follow this path, come here. Here you find that 199 is less than 200, you follow this path, come to this particular block, and here this is the leaf node. So this block should contain the block number 199. Okay. So here I can have one of two situations, that I have empty space within this block where I can put this record number 199. So in such case, I can simply insert this 199 into this block. Of course, I have to ensure that even after insertion, the ordered nature is maintained. But if it so happens that this block does not have any empty room, I can have a situation that this block has an empty room. But here I cannot insert this 199 because in that case my search strategy will fail. Okay. So I always have to have a situation that whenever I want to come to this 199, then my search strategy should still be valid. So this 199 should go into this block, but I find that this block does not contain any empty space where this 199 can be placed. So in that case, what will be done? I have to break this block into two blocks. This leaf node into two leaf nodes, okay? And if I assume that every block can contain, say, 100 number of records, and following the condition that always a node should be more than half empty, and a block contains, say, 100 records, can contain 100 records, that means none of the blocks should contain less than 50 records. Okay. Now, this block was already containing 100 records. In that, I'm trying to place this. So what I do is, I break this leaf node into two leaf nodes. One of the leaf nodes will contain 51 number of records. The other one will contain 50 records. Okay. So if it so happens that, say, this 199 should come to this block. Okay. So what I have to do is, I have to read this entire block, get the records, insert this record into this block. After that, what I get is total of 101 number of records. Break that 101 number of records in 51 and 50. 51 number of records will come in one block, and other 50 number of records will come into another block. Okay. Now, when I do this, then you find that it may be necessary that I have to change this non-leaf node to ensure that still my search strategy will remain valid. Okay, so when I do this, what I have to do is, if you follow the search strategy, you find that always, say for example here, if I find that I have to follow this left link if the key which I am searching for is less than 500. I am following the right link when the key that I am searching for is greater than or equal to 500. Okay, that means in this path, in the right path, I should not have any record with a key value which is less than 500. Okay, so following this, what I have done is, here, because this node has been broken into two nodes, earlier I ensured that this right link was following to records for which the key value was minimum of 200. A value less than 200 was not possible here. Now, because I am breaking this block into two different blocks, so again the similar concept must be valid. So for that, what may be necessary that I may have to modify this particular non-leaf node, or if necessary, this may have to be broken into two non-leaf nodes. And that process should continue recursively until I reach the root node. Okay. So whenever you insert a record, what you have to do is, you have to go on checking all the parents to see whether the parents also have to be adjusted. And if necessary, a parent node may have to be broken into two nodes. And that process should continue until and unless you come to a situation that a parent is not to be changed. Or you come to a situation when the root node itself is changed. Right? Now, when I follow this and come to the root node, there may be a situation that the root node itself is to be broken into two different nodes. Right? So if the root node itself is broken in two different nodes, then I have to create another node which will become a root node. Links to these two nodes will be from that root node. So effectively what I am doing is I am increasing the depth of that. Okay. So insertion of any particular node, and similar thing will also happen in case of deletion. Maybe that while deleting, a particular node or a particular block becomes empty. In that case, I have to remove that block from the tree structure. And for that, again, a number of modifications may be needed. Okay, so insertion and deletion is quite complicated in case of this B plus T indexed files, but you get the other advantage that I can come to the required number of the required block in very less number of such operations. Okay, so for example, if every block can contain say 50 pointers. Okay, and your total number of records is say n, then you can find out, it will be something like this, that to find out a particular block it can be searched out in log n to the base 50 time order. Okay, so for example, if it was a binary tree, then I could have searched out for a particular entry in log n to the base 2 number of operations. If every block can contain such 50 entries, in that case, this can be searched in log n to the base 50 search operations. Okay. So in a number of applications, you find that this search time is very critical when I can go for this kind of tree-structured file organization. But of course, at the cost of upgradation of the file. Because whenever I want to insert a new record or I want to delete a record from an existing file, then all these modifications are to be done. Now, these are the different cases of indexed files. In one case, we have said that it's indexed sequential file. And here also you find that the basic structure is a sequential structure. Because ultimately, the blocks which contains the records, within that, the files, the records are organized in a sequential manner. So even these are sequential file structures. And on top of that sequential structure, we are putting some indexing. And here the indexing is in the form of a B plus tree. We can also have another kind of indexing, indexed files, which are called simply indexed files or fully indexed files. In case of sequential indexed files, what we have seen is the indexing is done only with the help of key field. We are not interested in other fields. But in many applications, in many particularly database applications, what is needed is I may also have to search by using some other fields, not only the key field. So, for example, even in student's record, if I want to find out the students, the record of a particular student with a given roll number, then I can search out that particular record with the key field, which is the roll number field. Okay. Now, there may be search operation that I want to find out all the students who have scored a CGPA of, say, 8.5. or CGPA greater than 8.5. In that case, ideally my search operation should not be on the basis of roll numbers. Because even with the roll numbers, I can find it out if I go for an exhaustive search. But I should also have a search facility with the help of CGPA field. That is, all the students whose CGPA are greater than, say, 8.5, I want to get the records of those students. So in many cases, it is necessary or it is beneficial if the search operation can be done by more than one keys. So ideally, in such cases, what I need is for every field, I should have some sort of indexing. Okay, we should not claim that this will always be efficient. Because as we said, that this indexing method is efficient if your keys are unique. But when they are not unique, it is not very efficient. And in many cases, what I can have is, I can have one-to-many mapping. Okay. But still, if I have some sort of indexing for each and every field of the records in the file, the search operation will be more efficient in case of some application. Okay. So such a kind of files are known as fully indexed files. That is, for every attribute or for every field of the records, we have some indexing. Then the other kind of file that we have said is the hashed file. Or these are also known as direct files. We are already familiar with the hash operation when we have talked about the hash buffer queues. Here the main purpose is that quickly you go to the particular entry which is of interest. In case of buffer queues, what we have done is, we have taken the block number, performed some hash operation on it, hash function on it, then whatever the functional value you get, depending upon that, I identify that in which of the queues a particular buffer should reside. If that buffer resides in the buffer queue, if that block resides in any of the buffer queue, then it will exist only in that particular queue, it will not exist in other queues. So we can avoid many of the unnecessary search operations. The similar concept is used in a case of hashed file. Okay. Here also, the files will be what I have is some order of the records in a particular file, but in this case the ordering is not ascending or descending order of the key values, but it will depend upon, the order depends upon what is the hash function you use. Okay. So if for a record with particular key, say key value say KP, I perform a hash function on this KP, say H. If this KP, hash function on this record KP gives me a value of L, okay, then it is the lth entry in the file, this is the lth entry which contains the record with key value equal to KP. Okay. So whenever I store the records in the file, I find out the hash function of the records, different records of the file, find out what is the hash value, I put the record in that particular location which is given by the hash value. Okay, so when I organize the file organize, file will be organized depending upon the hash function. Similarly, when I want to search for that particular record in the file, again I take the key value, take what is the hash function, perform what is the hash function on the key value. Whatever hash value I get, I go to that corresponding entry that should contain the desired record. Okay. But you find that in hash function, mostly the hash function which is used is mod function. And this hash function is usually many to one, isn't it? So if I take say mod 4, hash function as mod 4 function, then with 0, 4, 8, 12, 16, for all these values, I'll get the mod value equal to 0. Okay, and typically any hash function that you use, mostly they are many to one functions. Okay, so if it is so, then if I am looking for a key, a record with key value equal to 0, I'll come to the 0th entry. If I am looking for a record with key value equal to 4, that then also I'll come to the 0th entry. But the 0th entry cannot contain more than one record. Okay, so what is usually done is, all the records in this particular file will contain a pointer field. Okay, so it is same as your queue concept. Okay, so whatever key value I want to search for that key value I find out the hash function, come to a particular entry in this file, okay, then this entry is nothing but a pointer to a sequence of records like this. Okay, then what I have to do is, I have to look for all these records to find a match for that particular key value. If there is any record within this linked list or within this queue which matches with the given key value, then I can simply extract that record. If it does not match with any of the key values of any of the records in this list, then obviously the record does not exist in the file. Okay, so this has to be done while formation of the file. If I want to insert a new record, I know what is the key value of that record, I perform the hash function. Using the hash function, I come to a particular location, say L within this file. I first check whether this location is empty. If it is empty, then this is the only record that is to be put with this particular hash value. So I can simply put that record in this location. If I find that this is not empty, I check the pointer, whether the pointer is zero. If the pointer is zero, then what I have to do is, I have to insert a new record, simply set the pointer. If this pointer is not zero, I come to the next record following this pointer, okay, then insert another record, set the pointer field of that record to point to this new record. Okay, so again in this case, the same advantage that we have got in case of buffer queue, the hashed buffer queue, the same advantage will also be obtained in this case. Of course, I have to go for some sort of linear search, but the amount of linear search is limited. Okay, so these are different types of file organ. Of course, the list is quite big. I'm not going to discuss all of them. These are only a few examples of different file organizations that can be used. Now compare this with the Unix file system that we have discussed, where we have said that different blocks of a file on the secondary memory has to be accessed to inode table of contents. Okay. Now this does not have any direct relation with the inode table of contents. In case of Unix operating system, what it assumes is whatever the file is, it is simply a sequence of bytes. Okay. It does not understand whether this is a hashed file or it is a fully indexed file or it is an indexed file or it is a sequential file, all these things. Of course, the sequential file is the one which is ideally suited for Unix operating system, because sequential file is nothing but a sequence of different records. Every record is of fixed size. So which quite conforms with the concept of a file consisting of a byte stream. Okay, but for other cases, the Unix file system, the Unix file manager does not understand what is the file content. Okay, so for example, in that case, I don't have anything called index file. I didn't have anything called B plus T index. What I had is simply some pointers in the inode table of contents, either direct pointers or indirect pointers, to point to different blocks which contains the file data. Okay. So if I go for this sequential indexed sequential file, this file data, a part of this may contain the index files, a part of that will contain main files. Now which one contains the index file or which block contains the record of the main file, that has to be decided by the application program. The Unix file system does not decide that. And that is not only true for Unix, it is true for most of the operating systems. I mean, the major file organization or file interface which is given, that is the raw format, that is the raw one. But understanding the content of file is up to the application. So if you do any course on database management, you will find that these are the file structures which are usually talked about. But in such case, between the file management, okay, and the application program, there is one more level. Okay, that is some data description or something like this. Okay, so whenever in such cases a file is to be read, it goes via that unit to the file manager. File manager simply returns the stream of bytes to the application, and the application will have to decode that or understand it properly to get the correct result. Okay, so you should not be confused about the type of file structure we have done in case of Unix with the help of inode structure and the kind of the file system that we are discussing. Okay, so with this I'll stop today. Next day we'll do about a distributed file system.